Yeah, some people do. Hi, welcome to Yogi Me. My name's Hannah. Thanks for joining. And we'll get started in a second. Mind is wandering elsewhere, maybe in the past or in the future. Just pull it back in to the present moment, noticing how your body is feeling right now. Start to notice your breath. Start to breathe a little deeper, a little fuller, in and out through your nose. Bring your palms to touch, and then exhale as you bring your hands back down to the mat. Inhale as you circle your arms up overhead. This time as you exhale, twist to the right. Bring your left hand on your right knee. Inhale as you reach back up. And exhale, twist to the left. Sit up nice and tall. Inhale, reach up. Again, twist to the right. Bring out your lungs. Inhale, reach up. And exhale as you twist to the left. Inhale as you reach up. And exhale as you bring your hands in front of you and come into a tabletop position. Shoulders over wrists, hips over knees. Bring your hands out. Point your fingers away from each other. And then you can stay here or start to rock gently side to side, giving a little stretch in the backs here, or in your wrists. And then turn your hand so that your fingers are pointing towards you. You can stay here or you can start to rock backwards just until you feel that stretch in your wrist. Or if it's too much, you can walk your knees forward. Between your shoulder blades. Inhale back to cow pose. And exhale as you round your spine, look back behind you. Inhale, one more time, coming into our cow pose. Look forward. And then exhale, round your spine. And then when you're ready, come back to neutral. Step your feet back to a plank. And then lift your hips up high, coming into your first downward facing dog. So pressing the mat away with all 10 fingers, scooping your tailbone up. Your knees can be bent here. Prioritize that length in your spine. And then when you're ready, spread your, drop your knees out wide. Bring your toes together and come into a child's pose. So bring your hips back towards your heels. Hands are reaching forward. Chest lowers down towards the mat. And then again, press your palms back into the floor. Start to tuck your toes underneath. And lift your hips up high, downward facing dog. And then when you're ready, look forward, bend your knees, and take a couple baby steps up towards your hands until you're in a forward fold. Again, your knees can be bent here. And then when you're ready, lift up halfway, bring your hands underneath your knees. Bring the crown of your head forward and lengthen your spine. Draw your shoulder blades together and down your back. Bring your tailbone straight back behind you. And then when you're ready, forward fold. Bend your knees and circle your arms up. Come up to standing. Inhale. And then exhale, bring your hands to your sides. Inhale, reach up, look up. And then exhale as you bend your knees and come back to forward fold. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale as you plant your hands, step your feet back to plank. And chaturanga lower to the floor slowly with control, all the way down to your belly. Untuck your toes and shine your heart forward, pressing into the floor with both hands. Take a few breaths here as you spread your collarbones and shine your heart. And then exhale as you touch your chin to the floor. Tuck your toes, press up to plank, and lift your hips up high, downward facing dog. And we'll take five nice deep breaths here.
Step your left foot to the back of the mat.
Inhale, crescent. And exhale, frame your right foot. Plant your hands, step back to plank. Chaturanga, lower to the floor. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift up. Downward facing dog. And we'll take 5 breaths here. Remember to use all 10 fingers, especially your thumb and your pointer fingers. Then inhale as you lift your right leg up high. And exhale as you step your left foot up in between your hands. Lift up to your crescent lunge. Take a nice deep inhale as you reach up. And then exhale as you spin your left heel down. Open up to a T warrior two. Right knee is bent. Sink down into your hips. And then flip your right palm up. Left hand comes to your left thigh. And reach your right arm up to reverse your warrior. Left hand can stay on your left thigh, or you can bring it back behind you and reach it forward. And then come back to your warrior two. Straighten your right knee. Reach forward with your right hand. Right hand to right chin. Left arm reaches up. And you can look up. And you can let your right hand slide down your chin. Or maybe bring it back up closer to you. Just keeping your hips nice and open. So whatever that looks like to you. Then when you're ready, lift up, back up, warrior two, rebend your right knee. Then cartwheel your hands down, frame your right foot. Snap your right foot back to plank and bring it through a flow, chaturanga. Lower to the floor, inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, touch your toes. And lift up to your downward facing dog. Inhale, your left leg up high. And exhale, step your left foot up in between your hands. Lift up to your crescent lunge. Take a nice deep inhale as you lift up. And exhale, open up to your warrior two. Right heel spins down. Your left palm up, right hand to right thigh, reach your left arm up to reverse your warrior. You can stay here, you can bring your right hand back behind you. Use your core as you lift back up, warrior two. Straighten your left knee. Reach forward with your left hand. Left hand to left shin, right arm reaches up. Remember to adjust to your personal pose, just keeping your hips open. Thank you. two, re-bend your left knee. And then cartwheel your hands down, frame your left foot, step back to plank, and bring it through a flow, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra, up dog. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift up to your downward facing dog. Engage your abs as you lift your core back up to your low plank. Bring your feet together, drop them over to the left. Reach your right arm up. Left hand can come forward. Reach your right arm forward over your right ear. Reach your right leg up. Right elbow, right knee, tap and send them out. Back together, tap, send them out long. One more time, tap, and send them out. And you can drop back down to your low plank. And then start to lift your hips up high, pressing into your elbows, into your forearms. And start to walk your toes forward. Coming into your dolphin pose. Just basically down dog on your forearms. And you can stay here or you can look forward and bring your nose in between your thumbs. Tap and then send them, then come back to your dolphin. You can do that two more times. Bring your nose in between your thumbs. And come back up. And then tap your nose. And come back up. And then from your dolphin pose, bend your knees and set your knees out wide. Big toes together. And we'll meet in child's pose. Pulling your hips back towards your heels and pulling your chest down towards the floor. Really lengthening your spine. to keep it intentional. And then press your hands back into the floor gently. Start to tuck your toes. And then lift back up to your down dog. And then start to walk your feet out wide, maybe as wide as the mat. And then maybe a little bit wider, as long as the floor is not too slippery. Just see how that feels, how much more stability you can get. And then maybe start to walk your hands back. See if you can come into a wide leg quarter fold. Then bring your hands to your hips and slowly lower, slowly lift up to your standing pose. Bring your feet together. So root and ground down into your right foot. Bring your hands to heart center. You can keep them on your hips. Start to lift your left heel up off the floor. Left knee comes out. And you can leave your left heel resting here. You can bring your left foot to the inside of your calf or help it along to the inside of your thigh. And once you have found a nice base here, you can start to grow your branches any way you'd like to. Chair poses to just reset. And then root and ground down into your left foot. Let your right heel peel up off the floor. Right knee comes out. And you can kickstand. Bring your right foot to your calf or to your inner thigh. Chairs. And then heel toe your feet out, just a little wider than hips distance, but not too much wider. Point your toes a little bit out. And then we'll come into our yogi squat. So sink your hips back, really far back in space, and start to bend your knees. And come into your squat. Stopping whenever your body tells you to. Try to keep your spine nice and long. Then once you've found your malasana, you can maybe rock a little bit side to side, if that feels okay. And then when you're ready, you can come sit. sitting down on your butt. Bring your legs out long. Sit up nice and tall. Inhale as you reach your arms up. And exhale as you fold forward. And you can always keep your knees bent if that's more comfortable. More nice deep breaths here. And then round your spine as you come back up to sitting. Spread your feet out wide. Squat is comfortable. Make sure your toes aren't flexing inward and pointing up. Nice and tall. And inhale as you reach out. And exhale as you fold forward. Trying your best to hinge from your hips. You want, instead of reaching forward, you can grab your legs or your feet. Here. And then round your spine as you look back up to seated. Bring your feet back together. Then you can round your spine and come all the way down to your back. Bend your knees and bring your feet underneath your knees. Hands come down to your sides. Plant your palms, or sorry, your plant the soles of your feet about hips distance. And press into your feet using your leg muscles. Press your hips up high. Bring into your bridge pose. One more time, press into your feet using your leg muscles. Press your hips up high. And you can wriggle your shoulders underneath you. Get a little bit deeper of a back bend. Maybe your hands clasp together underneath you. Pull your chest in towards your chin. Breathe. And then unclasp your hands and slowly lower your hips back down to the floor. Pull your knees in towards your chest and give yourself a little hug. And set your feet back down on the floor. Right ankle crosses over your left knee. Right knee comes away from you. Pull your left thigh in towards you, as much or as little as you like. You can grab the back of your thigh, you can grab your left shin. To center. Hug your left knee in. Send your right leg out long and set it down. Left arm comes out to a T. Right hand guides your left knee over to the right side. And if your neck allows, you can look towards the left. your chest. And then grab the outsides of your feet with your hands, reaching the soles of your feet up for a happy baby. You can always grab the backs of your thighs instead of your feet. You can gently rock side to side. Taking your time to get there, our last pose will be our final resting pose, Shavasana. You can take this laying flat down on your backs with your hands out to your sides, or you can bring the soles of your feet together, or you can climb the butterfly, or you can keep your knees together, bring your feet out wide. Whatever's most comfortable for you once you settle in. Start to just let go of any extra tension, any stress you might be carrying that you might not have even noticed in your hips or in your shoulders or in your jaw or in that space between your eyebrows. Start to wiggle your fingers, wiggle your toes, roll your wrists and your ankles. And then taking your time, we'll begin a comfortable seated position, similar to how we started class. On an inhale, start to circle your arms up overhead. Bring your palms together, and then exhale as you bring your thumbs to heart center. Gently pressing your palms into each other. Thank you for sharing your practice with us today. The light and love in me honors the light and love in you. Namaste. Thank you.